السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونتوب إليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار عباد الله Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, when Jibreel alayhi salam came to our great Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam and asked him about the Islam and the Iman and the Ihsan, Nabiyuna alayhi salatu wasalam answered him when he asked him about the Ihsan, أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه فإن لم تكن تراه فإنه يراك. So to reach the highest level of being close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as you are seeing Him. If you cannot see Him, then be sure that He subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching over you. And this subject is one of the subjects that you'll find the scholars rahmahumullah ta'ala, they spoke about it, and you'll find the Quran talking to us about it in many ayahs, and Nabiyuna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the same. And they call this maqam al-muraqaba. That as a believer, you have to remember all the time that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching over you. So, and this is to do with believing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-Sami'a and al-Basir. Al-Sami'a is the all-hearing. Anything you say, wherever you say it, and however you say it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can hear it. And He's al-Basir, the all-seeing. So wherever you are, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can see you. You cannot hide yourself from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You might be able to hide yourself from the people, but you cannot hide yourself from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is something every one of us needs to think about it and to check. Am I applying this in my life or not? And there are areas that you can check to see if you are really thinking, believing, observing, implementing this issue or not. Now, when al-muraqaba in your mind, in your heart, you are thinking about it all the time, one of the main fruits that you can gain is taqwa Allah fi sirri wa ala, fi sirri wal alaniya. That you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in open and in the hidden matters. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَقَدْ وَصَّيْنَا الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ وَإِيَّاكُمْ أَنِ اتَّقُوا اللَّهِ. We advise those who been given the book and you that to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Nabiyyuna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, اتَّقِ اللَّهَ حَيْثُمَا كُنْتُ وَأَتْبِعِ السَّيِّئَةَ الْحَسَنَةَ تَمْحُهَا وَخَالِقِ النَّاسَ بِخُلُقِ الْحَسَنِ. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wherever you are, follow the good deed, follow the bad deed with a good deed, it will wipe it off, and treat the people in a nice and kind way all the time. And the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave this wasiyah to Abi Dharr radiallahu anhu, usika bi taqwa Allahi fi sirri amrika wa alaniyati. Wa idha asa'ta fa ahsin, wa la tas'alanna ahadan shay'an, وإن سقط صوتك ولا تقبض أمانة ولا تقضي بين اثنين. رواه الإمام أحمد. So النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام said to أبي ذر رضي الله عنه that I advise you to fear Allah سبحانه وتعالى in open and in secret. And if you do something bad, then do something good after that. And don't ask the people for anything. Even if your whip fall down, pick it yourself. Don't ask the people to help you. And don't take any trust from the people. And don't judge between two people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminded us in the Quran that He is al-Sami' al-Alim. He said in Surah Shu'ara, الَّذِي يَرَاكَ حِينَ تَقُومُ وَتَقَلُّبَكَ فِي السَّاجِدِينَ إِنَّهُ هُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who can see you when you are standing, and when you are prostrating, and indeed He is subhanahu wa ta'ala, the all-hearing and the all-knowing. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminded us in another ayah. He said, وَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَعْلَمُ مَا فِي أَنفُسِكُمْ فَاحْذَرُوا. Know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what's in your hearts, so be aware of Him. أَلَمْ يَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَعْلَمُ سِرَّهُمْ وَنَجْوَاهُمْ وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَّامُ الْغُيُوبِ. Did they not know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows their secrets and when they talking to each other in secret, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows all the unseen. And he said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَخْفَى عَلَيْهِ شَيْءٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَا فِي السَّمَاءِ. Nothing can be hidden from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the earth or in the heaven. And one of the great ayahs, brothers and sisters, that I remind myself and remind every one of you to make this ayah in front of your eyes all the time, to keep it in your mind and in your heart. أَلَمْ يَعْلَمْ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ يَرَى. Haven't he know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is observing, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can see you? Remember this, brothers and sisters, when the shaitan try to mislead you and ask you to do something, and you think there is no one is watching. Remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching over you. If the shaitan asks you to be with a woman, or for the woman to be with a man, and you think you are hiding yourself, remember, إن الله يرى ألم يعلم بأن الله يرى. If you think you can steal something and no one is watching there, remember, إن الله يرى ألم يعلم بأن الله يرى. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminded us, very detailed ayah, وَمَا يَعْزُبُ عَنْ رَبِّكَ مِنْ مِثْقَالِ ذَرَّةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَا فِي السَّمَاءِ ولا أصغر من ذلك ولا أكبر إلا في كتاب مبين. There is nothing hidden from your Lord, even if it is the way of atom, in the earth or in the heaven, even if it is smaller than this or bigger than this, it is in a book, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows about it. Brothers and sisters, this matter, as I said, is very important, and definitely, it will change the way that you are thinking and the way you are acting when you remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching over you. And mashallah, most of you here, you are students doing masters and PhD, and you know the new technology these days. And I'm sure you know these days that these programs, they can follow you. Your phone will tell you where did you go, what you've been searching. Your phone, when you try to compare the knowledge of this phone to the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you cannot compare that, because you are comparing nothing to the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Almighty. Now this small device, as I said, can follow you where did you go, and also can tell you how many minutes you spent on these apps. And when you search in Google, it will tell you what you searched months ago, tell you all of these things. Now, we are driving, and we see the speed cameras, and they are registering what we are doing. And if you go to the court, you cannot deny that you were speeding at that time. And remember, brothers, again, all these devices, when you compare it to the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are nothing. So think about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty. As humans, we are shy to do something wrong, sometimes in front of our children, or in front of your parents, or in front of a religious person. But you are not shy in doing the same thing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لا تجعل الله سبحانه وتعالى أقل الناظرين إليك. Don't make Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the lowest, that He is observing you, watching you. Remember the majesty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the time. And definitely, this will change the way that you are thinking and how you are doing all the things. And I'd like to remind you, brothers and sisters, of this hadith. عن ثوبان رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال لأعلمن أقواما من أمتي يأتون يوم القيامة بحسنات أمثال جبال تهامة بيضا فيجعلها الله عز وجل هباء منثورا. قال ثوبان يا رسول الله صفهم لنا جلهم لنا ألا نكون منهم ونحن لا نعلم. قال أما إنهم إخوانكم ومن جلدتكم ويأخذون من الليل كما تأخذون ولكنهم أقوام إذا خلوا بمحارم الله انتهكوها. Nabiyuna Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, in this hadith narrated by Thabba'an radiallahu anhu, saying that there are group of people, They will come on the day of judgment with deeds with like mountains of Tuhama, a place in Arabia. And the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, then these people will come with all these great deeds, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make it nothing. So Thawban radiallahu anhu, when he heard the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying that, he said, O Prophet of Allah, tell us about them, who they are. Maybe we are amongst them and we don't know. And Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, he said, they are your brothers from the same, and they are praying at night as you pray. Look at the high level these people. They are praying. They are doing all good things. Even they are praying at night. But what is their problem? Their problem is, if they have an opportunity with any of the things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made haram, then we'll take the opportunity. Astaghfirullah. Examples, if he's with a lady, she's not his wife, and they are in one place, then he might commit zina. If he's in a place and he's an opportunity to steal, he will steal. If there is no one watching and he can cheat, then he will cheat. إِذَا خَلَوْ بِمَحَارِمِ اللَّهِ تَهَكُوهَا. Why Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, brothers and sisters, is warning us about this? Because Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam telling us about something comes to the minds of the people. This is how Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam trying to fix our minds and our hearts and think all the time about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's saying, yes, this is how the people might act. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, يَسْتَخْفُونَ مِنَ النَّاسِ وَلَا يَسْتَخْفُونَ مِنَ اللَّهِ وَهُوَ مَعَهُمْ إِذْ يُبَيِّتُونَ مَا لَا يَرْضَ مِنَ الْقَوْلِ. They are hiding themselves from people, and they don't hide themselves from Allah. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with them, with His knowledge, observing them, watching them. But they are ignoring that, and committing all these haram things. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save all of us from committing all these type of sins. And I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make all of us among the people who listen and adhere. Astaghfirullah wa antum mukin. Alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. Wa afdalu salatu wa tamu taslim ala nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he spoke about the seven categories that they will be under the shade of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of judgment, he said, وَرَجُلٌ دَعَتْهُمْ رَأَةٌ ذَاتُ جَمَالٍ وَمَالٍ إِلَى نَفْسِهَا فَقَالَ إِنِّي أَخَافُ اللَّهِ. A man that a wealthy woman, a beautiful woman, called him to commit haram, and he said, I fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Very short story, that there was a woman working in the market, and a man came and started to talk to her, buying something from her, then said, why you don't come with me? And he kept pressing her until she accepted to go with him. So she went with him, and they went to the house, closed all the windows, and she said to him, be sure that you close all the windows. He said, I close all the windows. Close all the doors. He said, I close all the wall. Put the curtains. Then she said to him, are you sure that you closed all the windows, all the doors, everything? He said, yes. She said to him, no. There is still one door, you didn't close it. He said to her, which door? She said, the door of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's watching you. You cannot close that, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Sami al-Basir. Brothers and sisters, remember this. When you are in your own, when you are serving the internet, when you are texting, when you are watching films or videos, especially when it is haram, remember this. Yes, you are in your room, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what you are doing. And remember that you will be asked about this on the Day of Judgment. Brothers and sisters, let us, all of us, remember this. When we talk to the people, when we deal with the people, when we are treating our wives or the husbands, our children, our friends, the people that are working with them, and I am sure if all of us apply this in our life, I'm sure our life will be changed to the good, inshallah ta'ala. And I'd like to take this opportunity to congratulate all the brothers and sisters who are graduating today. And I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help you to be in the service of the Ummah and to help the Ummah to improve towards implementing Islam in our life and to be the messengers of this deen wherever you are. And when you go back to your countries with all these certificates and qualifications, remember us in your dua, inshallah ta'ala, and keep the covenant between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala an yaghfir li wa lakum wa an yatuba alayhi wa alaykum wa an yaj'alana jami'an min alladhina yuraqibuna Allah fis sirri wal alan. Wa akhir da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin wa akhir salam.